Yinga too, is they don't have citizenship rights. Under what year was that law? 1982. So they, under that law, they don't have that access. So one of the things she did come forward and say, we need to change citizenship law in Myanmar to address these issues. Politically, she's not touching it right now because the 2015 election. And one of the ways this is being utilized is once she steps up and says, we need to protect the Rohingyas, then the hardliners within government, there's a strategic point to this, and the hardliners in government are not wanting to hand over political power to her in 2015, because when they do that, they do not have security that they have amnesty for the human rights violations they've committed against anyone in the country. So they're using this as a key point, that if she kind of finally comes forward from international pressure to say something, that then they can say, oh, see, Suki is actually on the side of people that we consider not to be even from our country. So they want to utilize that point, and that's one of the key reasons for not yet saying anything.
Thank you. Yeah, Gongs and Suki, because many questions all the time you have to answer about this lady. And actually, the problem, the thing is, election fever. Election fever mean, I'm not telling she is a power move, nothing because say about that. But this is the human nature. There should be something, you know, to govern the, to be elected as a ruler or as, the community member. What she think is, the 80% people of Myanmar are Buddhist. She is also Buddhist. When the genocide against the Rohingya has been started in June 2012, from very beginning about the Tango case, it was at the end of this time, we are the 10 people we have got killed. She strongly speak out. In the newspaper, they mentioned 10 Kala was killed or something. Kala mean, like in America, nigger, hate usage against the Muslim or any foreigners. The black people or white people, white Kala and, the black Kala. So Dong San Suu Kyi said that why you are using this kind of hate words. And they changed in the newspaper in the meantime, say Muslim, using the Muslim instead of Kala, nigger. And also he used to meet some Muslim, the local leaders, community leaders. At that time she did it. After that point, she didn't need to be stopped there. It's not against the Rohingyas, from the very beginning, the killing in the Tongo. Then when this started last spring, killing a lot of people and uprooted many houses and burned down thousands of houses in Sikwe, formerly known as Akka. And some, she was very silenced and she didn't speak after that. So maybe she thinks that this is not her cup of tea. She cannot solve this big problem, this becomes like war. And this is the responsibility of the government. And there is another thing, so she is not talking.